My days are so busy, it's making me dizzy. There's so much I gotta do. There's lunches and meetings and poetry readings and endless interviews. Gotta pose for a portrait and how I deplore sitting there for eternity. Then it's off to the inn where my innkeeper friend wants to name a drink after me. Then it's back to my room where I resume my attempt to write a hit. Just me and my beer and that terrible fear that I might be losing it. And it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard.
It's really, really hard. So very, very hard. I make it look easy, but honey, believe me, it's hard.
It's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard. It's
so incredibly hard. So inconceivably, unbelievably hard. It's hard to be the bard. Honestly, I don't know how I do it.
If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about. Think of me as your sidekick, helping you whenever I can. I'm more than just a woman, baby. When the pressure's coming, baby, let me be your right-hand man.
You're not a man. I'm the man.
Not hearing me. If you're ever in a pickle, you can call for me and quick you'll see how fast I run.
But I'm not in a pickle.
Forget the pickle. You and me should be a team for any dream or any scheme. That's how it should be done. For I can see in the background, you're smiling every now and again. Just to be a pretty lady, that would be a pity, baby. Let me be your right hand man.
Nick, you should probably listen to her. She's normally right.
Eat your cabbage.
Hey, I am stronger than you think. Don't be thinking I am tough. I am where you want to go when the going's getting rough. So when things are going badly.
But they're not.
They kind of are.
Well, things are fine.
But if they weren't.
But it's okay.
Love.
What?
Oh, come on. Quit trying to protect me.
Oh, can we please just change the subject?
No, not until I know that if you're ever in a fix and it's a fix you need to nix, then I'm your go-to guy.
You're not a guy.
Being so literal, baby, don't forget I'm not a shrinking violet, a solid rock. Am I gonna go peek and I'll crumble when the you know what hits the fan?
B.
There's no problem that's too big when you're married. That's the gig. So don't be a sexy pig. If it's asking too much of you, it's all because I love you. Let me be your right. In fact, I'll tell you that I'm right.
What are you doing now?
Oh, I'm gonna get you boys some meat. Baby, I'm your right. Put up a fight. I could be your right. Starting here tonight. Let me be your right. Man.
God, I hate Shakespeare. That's right, I said it.
No!
I do, I hate Shakespeare.
Why?
I just don't get it how a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the brightest jewel in England's royal crown. Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare. His plays are wordy, but oh, no, the great Shakespeare. That little turd, he has no sense about the audience. He makes them feel so dumb. The bastard doesn't care that my poor ass is getting numb.
How can you say that? How can you say that?
It's easy, I can say it, cause it's absolutely true.
Don't be a penis, the man is a genius.
Genius is he's fooling all of you.
But he's brilliant, what majesty flows from his pen. His poetry soars like a sweet violin. God's own inspiration like lightning doth strike him. And he captures my soul.
Jeez, you sound just like him.
Really? Thanks.
You should hate Shakespeare.
Well, I don't. I try to emulate Shakespeare.
Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the bard. He's such a pompous little man.
Why is it a problem to admit that I'm a fan?
Because he's a hack with a knack for stealing everything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that the man really knows how to write a bitch and play? You wish you could pen one.
We wish we were in one.
I just wish that he would go away.
Well,
Well, that's not going to happen because everyone I know say that he is the greatest writer that England has ever known.
And that's another thing I hate about Shakespeare is all the twits who bloviate about Shakespeare and how they prattle on about his great accomplishments. Well, la-di-da-di-da. And how once he starts or stopping, there's no stopping them. And then it's blah, 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 Shakespeare. He walks in, it's dum-da-dum-da-da, Shakespeare. He's holy court and they say, Will, you're such a genius and your writing is divine. A rose by any other name is such a clever line. And they're all, ooh, and he's all stop. And they're all, yeah, and I'm all, and I'm really getting sick of it.
I think by now we sort of know you hate Shakespeare.
Shakespeare, the way he feigns humility when all he does is gloat. The way he wears that silly frilly collar around his throat. The poster child for why no one should ever procreate. Take a shorter listen, I will give it to you straight. Every little thing about Shakespeare is what I
hate. He hates, he clearly, surely, really, truly hates Shakespeare.
Don't hate.
Oh, I love a lilting line of lyrical alliteration.
Who doesn't love alliteration?
And I'm like, whoa, when the phrases come together like a consummation.
Oh, what sweet elation.
I love the places that words let me go.
I love the way that your words move me so. I love that you feel the same way I do.
And I love, you know that I love, you know that I love.
Me too.